Hello, welcome to my garage. Today we're going to work on the encoder or resolver for the motor of the Volvo. I have purchased from our friends in China an encoder. Or no, this is the resolver. Complete with a certificate of quality and wiring diagram. I've labeled the wires up so I can attach it more easy later on. This is the resolver with the 4-pole rotor that goes in there. I've put my 3D printer to work to make me something I can put the resolver in. I've made this one that goes on to there, and then my rotor slips in here so I can manually spin it and see what the brain board thinks of this system. To build this on the motor is quite difficult. I've been thinking about it a lot and I think it's very hard to get it working properly with not too much tolerance. I also have another option. I have the Melexix MLX 90380. That's an sine cosine chip. You can hardly see it, it's very small. And that works with a special magnet. That should be more easy to build onto the motor, and the brainboard should be able to work with this. So I'm going to try both. First I'm going to test them if I can get them hooked up and working. And then I will make a decision on which one I'm going to build onto the motor. If you like this kind of videos, don't forget to subscribe. Let's get started. Power supply. These are the extra 3.3 volt and the ground. I got them from the Wi-Fi adapter. I have now the resolver connected and I have it, I can spin it around to see what happens. I have put the ink mode to resolver because it's a resolver that's connected now, and then I go to spot values. And I have my up mode is run, and I have here my angle. It now says 297 degrees. And when I turn on the plot, you can see it's going between 158 and 164, and when I start turning, let's see if we can make the graph a little bit more smooth. Now, to get it a bit more smooth, I up the data limit points and the burst length. And then we'll try again. And it's, as you can see, it's about 360 from zero. So it looks like this resolver works and can communicate with the brainboard. Let's see if we can get the MLX chip also to work.
This is the diagram I have to make.
Well, it seems like the chip is working. Let's print a jig so I can make it a little bit more steady so I can test it with the main board. I have this made up, the MLX chip with the wires and the capacitors in. I've used my 3D printer to get a little jig. I have the magnet, so I can put this one over here, change the distance. I also want to know what distance I need to set it to. And then when rotating this magnet, we should see something happening.
So let's get it connected and then let's see if this one also works.
Volt. Ground. I'll use the inputs for the encoder. Let's power it up. The lights start blinking. In the software we go to ink mode. I'll try the sine cosinus. I've got an angle. Let's make the plot. Wow. When I'm keeping it close, it's working perfect. When I go a bit further, this is too far. It's now doing strange things. Yeah, I keep this as the maximum distance. That is about 11 millimeters, and the minimum is 10. Closer the better, it seems. Now I'm going to try to fit the resolver chip to the motor. I'm going to drill out this hole so this one fits inside, and then I'll glue it in with some heat resistant epoxy. And for the magnet, I'm going to stick it onto the axle of the motor. I have enough space between the axle and the cover, so that should not be a problem. At first I wanted to drill a small recess into the shaft, but it's too hard. I can't drill in it, so I'm going to just glue it on. For precise gluing and drilling, I'm going to use some 3D printed jigs, so hopefully I get it quite centered, the magnet to the chip. That was tough drilling. I thought it's aluminium, so I can go through it pretty fast, but even with a just sharpened drill bit, it was hard to get it done.
Well, the clue has set for about 3/4 of a day. So let's put the motor back together and see if the resolver works as I have put it in right now. This is the result. This one is nice and tight, and the magnet is also, I can't move it by hand. But I'm wondering what happens if it spins up to about 10,000 RPM. Well, let's see if I remember how I have to put it back together. Well, here we have the test setup again. I have the power feed, the brain board connected up to the resolver. I have the drive shaft in it so I can rotate it and block the other one. I have the computer ready. I run already a little plot. It's jittering between 124 and 126.5, so that should be fine. Block it. I can't see the screen. Well, it's looking like it's giving a reasonable from 0 to a lot higher. It's running from 0 up to more than 350, so it should be around 360. So now I have a resolver. The motor can go back. Well, the motor is back in. I have everything attached. I have the board running at the moment. I have made some changes to the software. I have now the latest FOC software in it, the version 5.32. I've changed the parameter of the the pull pass to 5. I have no tag or anything on the motor. Now let's see what happens. If I go to a manual ID, I have 150 volt on the system now. Let's
I have the manual ID of about 5. It starts whining. And when I go up to... Oh, it tripped an overcurrent, I think. Overcurrent, it's now off. I must keep it not too long on. Turn it back on. It's now running again. And if I go to... manual ID of 20. And back to 0.
It runs, and even quite smooth. So now it's time to start tuning the motor. But that's not for now. If you like this if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. See you on the next one.